Arthur Brooks, president of AEI, author of the new book, Pretend to Love Your Enemies, you didn't put a pretend in there, how decent people can save America from the culture of contempt. And the reason is that we're old friends, you're too young to be my mentor, but the two books that you wrote previous to this, everybody should read, The Road to Freedom instead of Serfdom. Mm-hmm. And what was the other one?
The Battle. Yeah.
About what we're facing, and how prescient was that we're going to face socialism again in our lifetime.
And you read the conservative part, too.
And the conservative part, too. And I paid Andrew $1 a page to read The Road to Freedom.
Right.
And then he actually charged me for the index.
Yeah, the index. He charged you for the index?
Oh, yeah. Charge me for that.
That's capitalism. I like that.
Yeah, at least maybe you learned something from any. It didn't really work. But this one, when you sat down, I said, and I'm not going to mention any names and what side of the aisle they're on, but there are people that I will never, ever, ever, ever love.
Okay.
So and I can. There's nothing but disdain and contempt, and I'm sorry I feel that way.
I would never guess.
I'm not going to mention any names. Did you see the Kavanaugh hearings?
Yeah,
now, maybe I'm talking about Lindsey Graham.
Yep.
Maybe I'm talking about Blumenthal. Maybe. I could be talking about either
one. Who knows?
Nobody has any idea who I'm talking about.
Yeah.
But then you said, I don't really have to. I just need to pretend that I do.
So here's the deal, Joe. 70% of Americans, actually 93% of Americans, hate how divided we've become as a country. Mm-hmm. 1 in 6 have stopped talking to a family member or close friend because of politics since the 2016 election. Mm-hmm. I do 175 speeches a year. One question I ask in front of every audience is, how many of you love somebody with whom you disagree politically? Every hand goes up.
Yeah.
The problem is not that you don't have disdain for certain people. Of course you do, but the truth of the matter is that the country is being ripped apart because there's an outrage industrial complex in media and in politics and on campuses and in entertainment saying that we have to hate each other if we disagree.
Thank you, Arthur.
We don't have to do that. And this is a guidebook. This is not a problem book.
Really? Okay. When are certain sectors going to start loving the duly elected president of the United States? You think you're going to get some cooperation from that side?
But I can. What
you don't.
Do,
you
I
don't.
Think.
You won't. You never will.
Here's the deal for you, Joe. Here's the deal in the book. This is a solutions book for individuals. Here's the problem. When you hate somebody with whom you disagree politically, you're not separating their ideas from the person, and the result of that is you will never persuade the person. Nobody in history has ever been persuaded with hatred. So you'll be more persuasive, and I got the brain science of this book, the solutions book, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You can be a happier person if, when somebody treats you with contempt, which they're going to within the next 20 seconds on Twitter,
I know.
You actually respond.
How do you think the mainstream media felt about W? How do you think they felt about McCain when he was running for president? How did they feel about Romney when he was running for president? How do they feel about now, which is classic?
Yeah.
But there's no... You gotta toughen up. You gotta fight fire with fire. You're not gonna have any cooperation from the people that write all the newspapers and do all the,
Look, Joe,
put all the Twitter, Facebook, how are you going to do it?
I have better than fire. If you answer contempt with contempt, you'll never persuade anybody. Nobody who's watching will be persuaded, and you'll be less happy as a person than you need to be. Here's the deal. I got the data in this book. I show that when you answer contempt with greater respect, other people like it more. They're more persuaded by it. We have a fighting chance of winning the country for your party.
Did you bring a copy of the book? Can I see? I'll read it. Can I read it?
I will give you a copy of the book. I will absolutely.
Well, I'll be happy. I'm happy. I'm happy with everything except
here.
But I'm happy with my life. I'm happy with my family. I'm happy with all that. I'm just not happy with the mainstream media.
I love his point. I think it's fantastic. I think it's absolutely the way everybody should look.
What about Amazon?
Is the status quo today worse than it's ever been? Because there's lots of
Civil War.
Civil War
was pretty bad.
We're more polarized today than any time since the Civil War, and it's completely unnecessary. We should be so grateful for living in this country. And it has to do with the fact that in media, particularly social media, we're siloing our news feeds. People are only listening to people with whom they agree. The leaders, the people who are firing us up for a living, are saying that the people who disagree with us are stupid and evil. We're right, they're stupid and evil, which is completely unhelpful to us. It's unhelpful to us. It's making us less happy and less persuasive.
I think one fight this with love is one thing, and rather than hate, it's the same. But could we fight it also with regulation of social media or mainstream media?
That will help. What we need to actually is get rid of anonymity on social media. That is really the enemy. And what we can do personally is commit to never being anonymous and never interacting with anybody who's anonymous on social media. And the social media companies should start cracking down on anonymity because it's an existential crisis.
You don't think one or the other side is more guilty than the other at intolerance or at, I mean,
so, of course I think that. But the point
is, so you realize what I'm,
of course,
what I'm alluding
exactly.
to here.
You and I agree on politics. You and I have always agreed on politics.
Okay.
But in point of fact, if Joe Kernen and Arthur Brooks, Becky Quick, want to be more persuasive politically, the only way to do that is to answer contempt from others.
How can I like someone who blew 100,000 jobs in New York City for pie in the sky? Unrealistic, policies that only lead to hell. To hell like Venezuela. How can I love a person like that?
If you say they're stupid and evil, it's going to happen again.
Are they not stupid and evil?
Whether you think they're stupid and evil is a different matter. If you say you're stupid and evil, people who are watching are simply going to lock down on one side or the other, and we're going to be in a stalemate forever, and this is going to happen again.
You know he's right. I've watched you do it on
Twitter.
When you watch somebody with humor, they say they're sorry,
I know.
And they say you're right.
I can't love these people because I think they provide a very good foil for
Joe, you deserve to be happier, and you deserve to be more
persuasive. No, I'm happy.
Happier. This is my point. And everybody who's watching is going to get the step-by-step instructions on how to be happier for people.
Given where we are and the state of play at the moment, can someone win in 2020 by taking this approach, or do they have to fight fire with fire?
Actually, that's a good
That's
point.
A great question.
Given how things are playing out.
The question is, I don't know that yet. And part of the reason is because we're in early stages of actually having a backlash against the outrage industrial complex in this country. You can't have a crummy product when 93% of Americans don't like it. Sooner or later, we're going to come back, and we always have, including after the Civil War. I mean, the whole idea of the self-improvement movement came about because people wanted to master themselves. They wanted to be happier, better people. But it took a while. Will it be 2020? Will it be 2024? It's not going to start earlier than each one of us learning to master ourselves and living a better life.
Yeah.
Come on, Joe. You want it.
I was around for Reagan too. And do you remember how they treated that guy? He was like stupid. He was an actor. His biggest co-star was a chimpanzee.
Why did he win it?
You're right.
I think he's charming.
He said
it wasn't charming. Is because he loved the people with whom he was. Look. I was from a very left-wing household. We heard that Reagan was stupid and evil.
The French horn.
We heard that Ronald Reagan was going to kick Granny out in the snow and get us into a war. But when I heard him in 1984, I said, he loves me. He didn't know me. That's what
I love you. I love you.
You got to come back and guest host. We will be right back with Biogen. You got to check this out, too. Come back and guest host.
I love you. Yeah, I love you, too, Joe.